God. Praises, glory and honor be God the Father, God the Son and God the Spirit. Praises, honor and glory be the Lord of Lords, King of Kings, living Son of God, Lord Jesus Christ, whom came and gave his life on the cross for humanity. Bible tells us, in the beginning, when God created man and woman, men and women choose to go against goodness of God. They question goodness of God. And God punished them because of their sin. Yet, God gave the solution soon after they sin against God. Solution is Messiah, eternal word of God, King of Kings, living Son of God, will step into the world and give his life for humanity so that people can spend their eternity with God as it was in the beginning. What do you think I am doing, sir? Yeah, that's what I am doing. So I am asking today, I stand here as a Christian and I want to ask basic questions about the rights of women. Approximately 100 years ago, women stood up and they wanted to fight for the equality between man and woman. Today, 8th of March is identified day for the International Women's Day. And I get to hear as a Christian that Muslims are making a claim that Muhammad is the best feminist ever, as well as Muhammad is the one who offers equality between man and woman. As a Christian, I simply want to challenge that silly claim. I want to ask the basic question, does Islam really and really teaches equality between man and woman? According to Christian scripture, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Lord Jesus Christ stepped into the world and gave his life for man and woman. According to Christian scripture, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Lord Jesus Christ. It's fine. It is the grace of God is just pouring down. It's fine, brother. As Lord Jesus Christ offers eternal life for men and women, he also identifies the same value, dignity between man and woman. I want to ask the question, does Islam offer the same thing?
Yes.
Are you Muslim? Yes, okay. Help me out. Do you believe Islam, are you practicing Muslim?
Yes.
Do you believe Islam teaches men and women are equal, as well as Islam gives the same right to husband and to wife? Where does it say? Can you come close? I can hear you better.
One another. All with the key. The kingdom of Olumba, 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 say love one another.
I can't remember it exactly.
Olumba, say love one another.
The last sermon of the prophet was saying that no one is better than the other.
Olumba, say love one another.
So last sermon of Muhammad identifies men and women to be equal and none of them is above each other. Okay, so I'm gonna come to that. I just want to question what you just said, okay? Sorry. Brother, do you mind passing me that one? Yes. So in here, I have the biography of Muhammad. So what you said is not in the Quran. If I am wrong, please confront me. So it is not in the Quran. It is not what something Allah says. And then in here, I'm gonna ask you. I'm gonna kind of read the last sermon of Muhammad. Just give me a second.
Is that a Bible? What book's that?
This time is going to be
fire. Right, what is it?
No more water. What it says. The time of Noah.
Something else.
This time, the wise men.
Okay. Ma'am?
No more water.
Ma'am? What's your name? What's your name?
I'm Sophia.
My name is Satun. Nice to meet you. So, this is the biography of Muhammad. Okay? This is one of the earliest one by Ibn Hishaq. Okay? Actually, this is from Ibn Hisham because he writes down what Ibn Ishaq says. So, in here, this is page 651. This is Muhammad's last sermon. Okay? I read it and then you tell me what you said, why it's not here. Okay? You have rights over your wives and they have rights over you. You have rights, you have the right that they should not define your bed and they should not behave with open and sinless. If they do, God's allowed you to put them in separate room and to beat them. So this is Muhammad's last sermon, and then it goes on. Lay injunctions on women kindly, for they are prisoners.
The thing is, with the translation, you have to look at where it comes from. So the culture defines how you read the Arabic. There are so many different ways to translate a specific word in Arabic. Like, it can mean so many different things because it comes from the same root word that can be twisted depending on how you come from it. So if you look at the author, he probably has...
So this culture. It is written by very much devoted Muslim, and that very much devoted Muslim tells me in his last preaching, Muhammad ordered wives to be beaten. So you have a problem with that.
I'm saying that the translation, there are many different translations, and I'm sure if you look for, like, there are numerous translations of the last sermon, and so you are a product of your culture, so whoever wrote this is coming with his own predispositions of what his society has taught him to believe. So you can, because the Quran is in Arabic, and we are not, and if this is in English, they've had to kind of mix words, and so the words that they've chosen to represent in Arabic words is not necessarily correct. So prisoners, like, I don't speak Arabic, but I'm sure if I, as a Muslim, speak Arabic, they would tell me that there's actually so many different ways which the actual Arabic word could be translated.
So you don't have any problem with Muhammad to order wives to be beaten, but you have a problem with the word they are prisoners for you. Okay, you have a problem with that, but you are claiming actually, as it has been translated from Arabic, person who translated used his cultural background. Yes, okay. Yeah, okay. So now I think we identified the information you gave me regarding Muhammad's last sermon is not what Muslim scholars are telling me, okay? So, I'm going to make it much simpler for us, okay? Because I like simple things and I'm not that expert on English. This is the translation of the Quran. I've got Arabic here as well, if you want to see. I've got the Arabic here and then I'm going to show you the Arabic. This is translation. Can you go on your phone to check Surah 4, verse 34? I'm going to read it to you, okay? As I read it to you, please do follow up. Because I am very much concerned the image you were given about Islam and image about Islam you are trying to give it out. It is simply false. So have you found it? I read it for you. So So this is from the eternal word of Allah. This is the divine revelation from Allah. And this what Allah orders to human beings regarding when it comes to wife. Men are in charge of woman. By right of what Allah has given, one over the other, and what they spend from their wealth. So, righteous women are devotedly obedient, guarded in the absence, in the husband's absence, what Allah would have guarded them. But those wives whom you fear arrogance, advise them, forsake them in bed, and strike them. But if they obey you, seek no means against them. Indeed, Allah is ever exalted and grand. So this is very similar for the translation I read it from the Muhammad's last sermon. But difference is, this is Allah speaking according to you as a Muslim. Allah is saying, if husband fears, wife is going to be disobedient to him, he advise her, separate the bed, and beat her. How does it make you feel?
My argument still stands with what I was saying about translations being a product of the time. So I'm only 21. I'm still on my search for like what is the right thing, who I want to believe, what I want to believe, right? The way that I've been raised and the way that I've been taught, I have every much as equal right as my brother, as my father, as my mother. Like,
who teach you that? Who taught you that?
My mom.
Your mom taught you that. Did you, as a Muslim? Okay, so I really sympathize with you, the version of Islam which has been taught to you. But that's not the Islam which Quran teaches. So let me back up my claims. Let me back up my claims, and then I'll give you time to respond. So, first of all, the translation by Muslims, it says beat. If you have a question in here, I have my phone with the lexicon in it, okay? According to lexicon, according to dictionary, it is beat. But not like beat, brother, can I use it as a guinea pig? Not like beat like this, but beat the way you would beat the donkey, okay? Beat harshly. That's the first thing. I have lexicon here. You are very welcome to look at it, and you are very welcome to check it, and I strongly encourage you to check it. That's the first thing. Let me finish my statement. Second thing, I am disappointed. Mom, who looks after you, who cares for you, who loves you so much, because mom is biologically programmed to love you. Yet, your mom seems to fail to explain to you about Islam. Because Islam doesn't teach men and women are equal. Islam teaches two women is equal to the one man. That's Surah 2, 282. Muhammad says majority of women are in hell. Do you know why? Because you curse and you are ungrateful to your husband. Reason for that is because once a month you have your period. So that doesn't teach you and your brother, maybe the way your mom looks at you, sees you and your brother is equal and cares and loves you same way. But that's not what Allah and Muhammad teaches.
So you made many different points, but I want to answer the first about two women is equal to one man.
That was the second one. That's why.
You have to take everything within context. You're looking at everything with a literal meaning, but you can't do that with a Quran. There are some Muslims who do, but I don't necessarily follow that. Two women is equal to one man because at that time women didn't have the education that they needed to be able to uphold that in court. So like they weren't able to do maths, they weren't able to like stand up in the way that they needed to be witnesses at that time. But nowadays, I think we need to reform to how this culture works. And the one rule of Sharia law is you follow the land of the Lord of Sharia. Women have the same capacity nowadays because we've given the same opportunities, the same education. So one woman is equal to one man because we've been given
I strongly agree with you. I strongly agree with you. Sadly, if you are following Islam, Allah and Muhammad completely and fully disagrees with you. So, Quran is the eternal word of Allah. Okay? It is there from eternity beginning and it's gonna be there from eternity end. Muhammad is the best example for humanity to follow, and you must follow Muhammad with full submission. Whatever Muhammad did, whatever Muhammad said, you must be faithfully obeying them. And with all of his wisdom, Allah makes two women equal to one man. Why? Because one woman is gonna forget, they need second woman to remind her. Woman is deficient in mind according to Islam. But I strongly agree with you. I believe, I don't know how many degree this brother might have, but I believe if we go through the test, we might come up with the same result. You look at the leaders, we have woman leaders, but Islam disagrees. If you today claiming to be Muslim, and if you want to stay as a Muslim, basic information is you need to get rid of the Quran and get rid of Muhammad, because those are the teachings puts you, takes your value and dignity away. But where does it, it's not about the translation. Arabic is the same. It's not.
No, but there's so many ways that you can translate Arabic.
So
Arabic
what would be okay? Okay, give me the example.
Why has he let all through the ages make us try and work out what it is? If this was a real God, why would he just write it?
It's not about our age. Today, let me just make something clear. It's not about the age. Mother of believers Aisha was much, much younger than you when she had first sex with Muhammad. She was only 9 years old child when Muhammad in his 50s thought it was all right for him to put his private part in the private part of child. Okay? You are much, much older than her. Aisha, as the mother of the believers, tells us what Muhammad did. You are much, much older than her. That's in the time of Islam. Today, 16, 17 years old girls are speaking to the NATO. Today, 16 and 17 years old girls are going to the front line. You might disagree or agree with them, but they are standing up for something they believe and they are trying to bring a change. You can't give me the excuse, you are only 21 years old. Because your book, from eternity beginning to eternity end, discredits you, disgrades you, and takes your value away. If it is not beat, if it is just Arabic misunderstanding, can you tell me what other options you want to be in that verse? If it is up to the interpretation, can you give me your interpretation for the verse I read it to you? Yeah. Give me your interpretation for that. Would you like me to read it again? Do you remember it? Okay. How would you interpret that as a Muslim woman?
I'd have to research it more, like I know this stuff exists. you have to look behind the text, behind the context. So you can't just take a verse out of context, you have to look into it. And that's why I'm still like looking into it. So I took a point, and I'm going to go home and like think about it and read many different interpretations of it. But you can't exactly, you can't.
Let me give you something which has the context, okay? Let me give you something which has the context. So in here, I have something.
Her mother was Christian and converted.
So, sorry. I'm going to read you something in context. Okay? Sorry?
You have all your resources ready. Mine is just in my head and I feel like on the spot.
It's very one-sided.
I'm not asking you to be scholar. I already asked you what would your interpretation be. You said you want to go home and check it out. And then you said context and it's behind the context is important. So I want to give you one thing, another story, which has the context. And I think context is very clear. Okay? So... That's fine. So this comes from Sahih Bukhari, from the sayings of Muhammad, customs of Muhammad. Volume 7, book 72, hadith number 715. Okay? Rifa, divorced wife, whereupon Abdurrahman bin Azzabar and Quraiza married her. Aisha said that the lady came wearing a green veil, and comparing her to her husband, and shoved her green spot on her skin caused by beating. Woman comes to Aisha, mother of believers, and wearing a dress, and her skin is so much green. Okay. And those green is being caused by beating, bruises. It was the habit of the ladies to support each other. When Allah's apostle came, Aisha said, I have not seen any woman as much as the believing, suffering as much as the believing woman. I have not seen any woman suffers as much as Muslim woman. Look, her skin is greener than her clothes. When Abdurrahman heard his wife had gone to the Prophet, he came with his two sons from another wife. She said, by Allah, I have done no wrong to him, but he's impotent and is as useless to me as this, holding and shoving the fringe of her garment. Abdurrahman said, by Allah, O Allah's apostle, she has told a lie. I am a very strong and I can satisfy her, but she is disobedient and wants to go back to Rifa, who is her ex-husband. Allah's apostle said to her, if your intention to go back your husband, then no, it is unlawful for you to marry your first husband unless Abdurrahman has had sexual intercourse with you. Then Prophet saw two boys with Abdurrahman and asked him, are those boys yours? On that Abdurrahman said, yes. The Prophet said, you claim what you claim. By Allah, those boys resemble him as crow resemble to crow. Woman comes to Muhammad, comes to Aisha. Her skin is greener than her dress because of the bruise. The reason...
Come on, don't go that area. There's a lot of violence.
Ma'am?
Don't go that area. She's a young girl still. She's not mom. Okay?
Don't ma'am?
Go that area. Okay?
So her skin is greener than her dress. Can you tell me? Sophia? Sophia?
Quran is violence. Where your Bible is not violence. Don't go that area. Don't go that area because there's a violence in your Bible.
The dress of Aisha is so green. Sorry, Aisha's friend's skin is so green, which has been caused by beating. What would you say to her? If you were in that position, sorry? To her. So Prophet say to her, go back to this man and have sex with her. So Prophet say to the woman who has been beaten, you need to go back to this man and have sex with him. So she comes from abused husband, and then your prophet sends her back to home, the man who bruised her, and then says, have sex with her, with him. What would you say to her? If it was you. Sorry?
Sorry, I said I don't know, dude. I didn't mean to call you dude.
It's fine. I don't mind. This is Sahih Bukhari, Volume 7, Book 72, Hadith number 715. So I am asking, if you were there, and then if you have seen a woman who has been beaten by her husband, would you send her back to the husband? No, if you are in that place, would you send her back to the husband? Or would you say, oh, I'm sorry, what happened to you? Husband, why did you do this? Would you tell the husband of? Sahih Bukhari 772, 715. So what would you say to the husband, and what would you say to the woman?
Tell her your language.
She'll show you in a second.
Tell her, oh, Khatun, where's the five different Quran? Khatun,
Here.
Open. I challenge you in front of those people.
Wait, after I finish with the lady, I'll come to them.
No, leave the little girls.
Why? Do you think those girls are deficient in mind? You don't even want them to think and speak? That's just heartbreaking. I'm sorry that they treat you like this at speakers. Gonna just ignore them.
This is a change from 1,400. There's no two Quran. There's no two. Not even five. I have to pray.
I am asking the question. As a Muslim woman, what would you say to this woman who has been beaten and her skin is greener than her dress? She has been beaten by her husband. Muhammad sends her back to the husband. I am asking the question, what would you do? Sorry, what's the question?
No, I'm just reading it.
Yeah, that's fine. Can you read loud so people can hear as well?
I'd rather read it.
Okay, that's fine. You should trust your English.
Diverting, you're changing the sentence.
While Muslim lady looks into that, I'll continue. As we heard, Muslims are claiming men and women are equal because Allah and Muhammad gives them equal right. I am making the first point. Actually not. While two women is equal to the one man, and reason for that is because women are deficient in their mind. Why they are deficient in their mind? Anyone is Einstein to help me?
Read the Quran you're talking about.
Why women are deficient in their mind? Therefore, you are declared as deficient in mind. That's not only enough, you are deficient in your mind. Therefore, you are going to end up in hell. Muhammad says majority of women are in hell because they are ungrateful to their husbands. They curse frequently. They are deficient in their minds. Therefore, hell is the place. Muhammad, whom supposed to be the best example, saw them in hell. It is not only two women is equal to the one man. We saw that Allah gives divine lessons, stems in the Quran, that husband can beat the wife if they fear wife is going to be disobedient to husband. And what we saw is in the hadith that wife is beaten, and all Muhammad does is send this woman back to the abused home where she has to have... Sorry, what was your response, ma'am? Before you go, tell me your response. So you ask for the context, I gave you story with the full context.
He says that she's wrong. He doesn't say that she's wrong. He says that whatever your intention is, you know your intention. So these are your options, now you can pick.
So Muhammad doesn't give her option. If you are reading the same story, Muhammad tells her, go back to the husband who beat you, who gave you bruises.
What is the intention?
She wants to go back to her first husband. So she just a moment. She's married the second husband. Okay. Muhammad says, if you want to go your first husband, I don't care this guy gives you bruise or not, you must go and have sex with her, with him. What does he say? He has to have sexual intercourse with you.
No, unless he's had sexual intercourse with you.
So you have to have sex with this guy.
No, not you.
I can see you are trying to justify it, but can't you see there is something ugly going here?
If that is your intention, then know that it's unlawful for you to remarry.
So I am fall in love with my first husband. I end up marrying with someone else.
I'm gonna change each other's minds, but I'm gonna go back home and read up on this.
You really need to check it out. Even though you are only 21 years old, but when we die, our eternity is not affected by our ages. I am Christian. I believe Jesus is eternal Son of God. He died on the cross for the sin of mankind, and he offers eternal life to him, with him to everyone who believes in him. You don't believe in Jesus. If you believed in Jesus, you would simply reject this one, because that's not something Jesus teaches. It is heartbreakingly disappointed. On the International Women's Day, we get to hear justification for husband to beat the wife. We get to hear the justification where woman is sent back to the home where husband is beating her.
Bring the two. Come on.
I have got here six. Wait. I will show them to you. It is not only two women is equal to the one man. It's not only husband has power to beat the wife. We also see men whom supposed to be example to humanity without any shame beats his wife. Not only any of wife, but beats Aisha, the child wife. And today he has been followed by many, many people, and you can see Muslims are just trying to justify husband beating the wife in order to be faithful to Islam. I think that is heartbreaking. It doesn't stop there. Islam right to the husband, where husband can force himself to the wife however and whenever he wants. Ma'am, how does it make you feel knowing your husband can force himself to you however, whenever he wants? Let me ask question again. How does it make you feel as a woman knowing Allah divinely appoints husband to force himself to the wife however, whenever he wants?
And a man, and God, when he pray to the God. How you pray or worship a God when he pray to another God?
So that is the most silliest argument I heard, and it just helps me to understand. Sorry, what is the issue?
Yeah, putting their Quran on their feet.
This is speaker's corner, sir. They are just books.
Yeah, this is our book.
No, okay. I am Christian. I am Christian. I don't see them as a holy book, sir.
Yeah, Bible is a rubbish.
Sir, I am Christian. I don't see them as a holy book. Therefore,
I don't see that. I don't understand the speaker's corner, but you need to look about other sensibilities also.
I am very sensitive. Excuse me. Excuse me, sir. No. Excuse me. I am very sensitive. I am very sensitive. When Muslims call Jesus, he is not God.
So if I put a dictionary down,
if you put any book up there, right?
Sir, I am very sensitive. Yes. When every Muslim at speaker's corner tells me Jesus didn't die, I am very sensitive. When every Muslim at speaker's corner tells me Jesus is not God, these are just a book.
All right.
They are just a book. And you know what? No, sir. I'm gonna make my point. Can I make my public complaint to the Muslims? Brother. Can you please show me that? Brother Jasimo, can you please show me the law where it says I cannot be disrespectful? Please.
This is not allowed.
Please show me.
It's not allowed, right?
Please show me. Sir.
Cameras are not allowed here.
Sir, are you Muslim?
No, I'm not.
You are not Muslim?
Yeah.
So, I don't see those books as a holy book. Therefore, I see Lord... Just a moment. I see...
If they keep a Bible next to their feet, is that fine?
Sir.
Yes.
It's not only they keep the Bible. They call my God not a God. They insult my God. They tell me that Jesus did not crucify. I am sensitive. My feelings are hurting. But I am not complaining. It is speaker's corner. If you cannot handle, go home and sit with your mom. They are corrupted Qurans. Not holy Qurans, not holy books, corrupted. And it is very dangerous for humanity. Without any shame, police is telling me I should not put the holy books on the chair. My feelings are hurt. Today, I stand at speaker's corner as a woman, hearing that Islam teaches two women is equal to one man. My feelings are hurt as I stand at speaker's corner. I hear that Allah orders wife to be beaten. My feelings are hurt as I hear Allah sends Muslim woman to hell. My feelings are hurt
women.
When you call me I am rubbish woman. But I don't complain
rubbish
about you.
Women.
Thank you. I'll take that as a compliment.
Rubbish women.
But it doesn't change the fact.
You liar.
Islam teaches something dangerous to humanity.
Allah.
This is the simply fruit of Islam.
La ilaha illallah.
Allah is false God. Allah is mosque.
La ilaha illallah.
Praise be to the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Praise be to Lord Jesus Christ. The one who is gonna judge you one day.
Allah.
The one who nailed himself on the cross for you. That is the God we worship. We don't worship a God who simply discredits human beings. I'm going to talk about how Quran has been corrupted.
Liar.
No, you are taking the Quran here.
Liar,
you
sorry?
Rubbish.
You cannot take the Quran. You are
using. Liar, you are rubbish.
I can. I can. It's not my holy book, sir. I worship the Holy One. He is identified as Jesus. He is identified as the Son of the Father. He is identified as the Pierced One. He is identified as the Prince of Peace. He is identified as Wonderful Counselor. He is identified as King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Alpha and Omega. That is the Holy One, the one who came from the bosom of the Father, and the one who offers us the place in the bosom of the Father. That's the one I worship. That is the Holy One of Israel. Not those bones, books. They are just a book. And sadly, those books are affecting your eternity.
Rubbish.
Are you talking about Muhammad?
Rubbish.
I strongly agree with you.
Go
Muhammad is pretty
Italia,
much rubbish.
Go hospital, you rubbish.
Why are you discrediting me?
Rubbish.
Because Islam teaches you
rubbish.
To discredit me.
Rubbish women.
Thank you.
Rubbish.
May Lord Jesus Christ bring you on your knees. Don't talk.
Fuck you.
Don't talk to my brother like that. Don't talk to my
listen
brother
here,
like that.
Donkey. Fuck you. You ask police here, yeah, donkey. What?
Yeah, donkey.
Go to the police.
Donkey.
What is wrong with you, sir?
Stop in here,
what
rubbish.
Is wrong with you?
Stop in here, rubbish.
It is only Jesus Christ
Allah.
Who can help
Allah.
You to have peace with
Allah.
Yourself and has peace with
Allah.
God. It is only
is
King
Jesus?
Of Kings
which
who
Jesus?
Gave his life on the
which
cross for
Jesus
humanity will change and
which
transform
Jesus?
You.
Yeah, don't
not
yeah,
Muhammad.
Don't
not Islam, but living Son of God, the one who is seated at the right hand of the Father, and the one who is going to come and judge the world.
La ilaha illallah.
Can I just point out to you all, have you noticed, while I am talking about the place of woman in Islam, Muslims are not allowing me to speak. Is that because I am a woman? Or is that because, you know, the place Islam offers to humanity is very, very bad and dangerous. Even someone might call that as rubbish. But you can shut people down. You can go to the police and complain. Lord Jesus Christ still rules and reigns. Lord Jesus Christ still offers himself for humanity. And he offers place for humanity in the bosom of the Father for those who repented and accept him as their Lord and their Savior.
Irish and the Scots and the English.